There's another way to specify a complex number. For this other way, we have to know two things. Number one, we need to know the distance between 0 and the complex number that we're interested in expressing. Let's take z for example. So we need to know the distance of this. And the distance of this line segment is simply the modulus of z. Now, we need another piece of information, and that is the angle that is measured from the positive real axis to this line segment, which we call theta. Now, notice that once you have the modulus of z and this angle here, you can then tell me the exact location of z on the complex plane. So let's see if we can work out this angle theta here. The modulus of z is not difficult to obtain because we already have the number here is minus 2 plus I. So the modulus of z is going to be the square root of minus 2 squared plus 1 squared, and that is the square root of 5. To calculate the angle, what we're going to do is we're going to work with this angle instead within this triangle. So this is a right angle triangle. The height of this triangle is 1. The base of this triangle is 2. So tangent of alpha is equal to 1 half. Now, once you have alpha, you can calculate theta because theta is given by pi radians minus alpha. So if you take out your calculator and compute the arctangent of 1 half, you'll get roughly 0.4636476 and so on. And so theta would be roughly 2.6779 and so on. We usually use R to denote the modulus, and we'll write Z as R times cos theta plus I sine theta. And usually we abbreviate this as R times CIS or sis of theta. So sis theta represent this expression within the brackets. And in our case, R is going to be square root of 5, and theta is exactly pi minus arctangent of 1 half. And if you want to give an approximation, it will be 2.6779. Now, to convert a complex number from polar form to rectangular form, all you have to do is just expand this expression here, right? So the real part is given by R times cos theta. You can work that out numerically. And then the imaginary part is R times sine theta, which again, you can work out numerically. Now, there's something nice about having complex numbers in polar form. It makes multiplication of complex numbers rather easy. So suppose you have two complex numbers expressed in polar form. Say z is r1 cis theta 1, and w is r2 cis theta 2. Now, to multiply them, all you need to do is just take r1 times r2, and then cis theta 1 plus theta 2. And if r2 is non-zero, z divided by w is given by r1 divided by r2 times cis theta 1 minus theta 2. These results are not difficult to prove. The first requires using the sum formula for cosine and sine. And for the second one, what you need to do is you first rewrite this as z times the complex conjugate of w. And in the denominator, you have the square of the modulus of w, which is basically w times the complex conjugate of w. And once you do this, you can apply this up here to give you this. The details are left as an exercise, and I encourage you to work them out.